Fam, what's goody? Jordan Baywood here, and I'm a music producer and audio engineer, and today we're gonna be doing a mixing video breaking down a vocal compressor. It will be the last vocal compressor tutorial you'll ever need to watch, or your money back guaranteed. I'm making this series out of frustration. If you've seen the past two videos, we started with auto-tune and EQ, and now we're moving on to compression. I wanted to make a from scratch tutorial series like this because everybody was overcomplicating things and there was no system at which I knew how to mix a vocal. What's the correct order? What's the process of your brain works? And then when they did a tutorial from scratch, they would leave out a lot of things that left me asking questions, and I would try to look it up and then I would have to learn from someone else. So I just wanted to make an all-in-one series that breaks down step by step of mixing a vocal. And if you like this style of learning, please smash that like button and turn it blue, and confetti will go all over your screen right now. It's so cool. Just joking, it doesn't, but it really helps the YouTube algorithm if you hit that like button. That means more artists like yourself will be able to learn in a cool new way that hasn't not been taught like this on YouTube yet. If you like videos like this, also please smash that subscribe button, because I found out 76% of you that watch my videos are not subscribing. So I'm sure some of you guys forget. Right now, let's play what we got. This artist is Joey Holly. I work with him very closely. I produce all of his tracks. I engineer all of his vocals. So we're gonna hear it. I'm mainly only mixing the first part, and then later down in the series, we're gonna be mixing layers. We're gonna be mixing ad-libs. We're gonna be mixing dubs. We're going to be adding reverbs, delays, exciters, saturation. So stay tuned for that. Make sure you hit that subscribe button to get notified whenever any of those videos drop. So let's get right to it. First off, we went from without anything. We went, here's raw.
Wasted thinking about the way.
And I'll turn on the plugins.
Wasted thinking about the way you said that I won't make it. All I can think about is when I saw you naked. Fixing my life up, bullshit, cause I ain't changing. I say it too much, you retort and say I ain't shit. I say how I feel, but you don't
ever. Alright, so what we're gonna do now is I'm going to duplicate this track that we just put our EQs on in last video. I'm gonna drag up the main hook, and then I'm gonna mute these layers, okay? I don't like focusing on the ad-libs and layers till the very end. We're gonna add our first compressor. Now you can use any compressor you want. I'm gonna use all stock plugins for this whole series. This is a scary looking compressor because there's so many buttons. Don't mind about any of these until after, till you get a sound you want. And then you can switch these. These are gonna give you different tones of a compressor. We're going to just mess with the Platinum Digital. And the first thing I wanna do is mess with the threshold. And I like watching the graph. So we're gonna move this left or right until we see some compression happening. A compressor is going to make a vocal more consistent, because as you see in this vocal right here, that there's some low points right here, and then there's some really high points right here. And all we're gonna do is make sure this is controlled and nice to sit on the beat or sit inside the mix. So here we go.
Ain't shit. I say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in my mind. Ain't shit. I say how I feel.
So it's compressing a lot, so I'm gonna move the compressor to this threshold to the right, because I don't want it to get all that.
Ain't shit. I say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in my mind. Ain't shit. I say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in my.
Nice. Now that we got a threshold, you see how it's biting at that? It's bringing those peaks down, and it's gonna make it more consistent at a nicer level. So the ratio is how hard the compressor is going to be working. And with rap and hip hop, I like doing a higher ratio to get a tighter sound and a more consistent sound. So I'm just gonna increase this ratio till I hear.
Ain't shit. I say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in my mind. Ain't shit. I say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in my mind. Ain't shit. I say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in my mind. Ain't shit. I say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark.
Nice. It's sounding really consistent. It's in the pocket. Let's hear before and after.
Ain't shit.
I say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept, the dark in my mind. You see how all the words are staying in the same little pocket? And that's what a compressor is doing, where we got a vocal all over the spectrum and it's tightening up and giving it a consistency. Now, on this, amazing thing about this compressor is there's an auto button, and this is gonna auto release with the vocal, so it mathematically knows when it needs to be released. All now we're gonna worry about is this knee button and this attack. The knee, I like it all the way up. When it compresses, it's going to be smoother. I always like smooth, so I'm gonna go with a higher knee. In most cases, on compressors, there's not a knee, so don't even worry about that mostly. Next, you got the attack. Now, let's see what happens when I have a really fast attack. You're gonna hear a big difference. Say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in my mind, almost as black as my new car tank. Got stars in my eyes, so... When you have a slow attack, that's going to bring up your transients. So on a slow attack, you would use that on things like kicks, on snares, on things you want to really punch hard. So on a fast attack, let's hear what a fast attack sound like. Say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in my mind, almost as black as my new car tank. Got stars in my eyes, so sweet but feel I'm fucking heartless. I'm heartless, so I think I'm fucking... So on that, it's gonna bring the transients up as well. What I like doing is mid attack. So I go around like, let's try 50. I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in my mind, almost as black as my new car tank. So that sounds nice and smooth to me. Generally, with an attack, have it down the middle or have it a little slower. Just start there and then just practice going to the extremes where really slow or really fast. I always start in the middle and usually it sounds good right there. We can change this gain to increase the vocals or decrease the loudness of the vocals. Say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in my mind, almost as black as my new car tank. Got stars in my eyes, so sweet but feel I'm fucking heartless. That's what you're gonna do to get that nice vocal compression. I want to go through each one of these and just see what tone I like more with this vocal. Say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in my mind, almost as black as my new car tank. Got stars in my eyes, so sweet but feel I'm fucking heartless. I'm heartless, so I think I'm fucking... When it doesn't have an attack or release, as you see down here, that means the compressor was made with its own set in stone attack and release that it wants you to use. In most cases, it's going to be a mid attack and a mid release. I like compressors that don't have it because you don't have to overthink it, you know? And this one sounds really good. I'm liking the sound of this. So I like the Platinum and VCA, the classic VCA. So let's keep going. We got three more. Say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in my mind, almost. Say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in my mind, almost as black as my new... Not as smooth. Say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in my mind, almost as black as my new car tank. Got stars in my eyes, so sweet but feel I'm fucked. Alright, so I think it's between this classic VCA and the Platinum Digital. So let's go through these two again. Say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in my mind, almost as black as my new car tank. Got stars in my eyes, so sweet but feel I'm fucking heartless. I'm heartless. I like the sound of this one, but I like the consistency of this one. It sounds much smoother. This is where two compressors come in. This has a cool tone. Say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark. It's giving it a little more bite. So what we're gonna do is keep it on Platinum Digital. That's gonna be called our main compressor. We're gonna duplicate that. And now we're gonna go to this classic VCA and just lower this ratio to between 2 and 3. And we're gonna use this as a tonal compressor. But I don't want it to be an aggressive compressor because it was bringing out a little bit too much bite. So in order to do that, we lower the ratio and we're gonna mess with this threshold. Say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in my mind, almost as black as my new car tank. Got stars in my eyes, so sweet but feel I'm fucking heartless. I'm heartless, so I think I'm fucking... Say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in... You see how it's actually giving it beef in the mid-range and high range.
Say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept.
And it's not compressing much. I want to make sure that I have one compressor that's compressing heavy if needed, and then this lighter tonal one to be lighter, so under -5.
Say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in my mind, almost as black as my new car tank. Got stars in my eyes, so sweet but feel I'm fucking heartless. I'm heartless.
So before,
say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in my mind, almost as black as my new car tank. Got stars in my eyes, so sweet but feel I'm fucking heartless. I'm
perfect. So now we can, I guess we can duplicate that. And then let's hear it on the verse.
To go, I'm always fucking wasted, thinking about the way you said that I won't make it. All I can think about is when I saw you naked. Fixing my life up, bullshit, cause I ain't changing. I say it too much, you retort and say I ain't shit. I say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in my mind, almost as black as my new car tank. Got stars in my eyes, so sweet. We but feel I'm fucking heartless. I'm heartless, so I think I'm fucking.
Boom. That sounds great to me. I want to add a de-esser because we are pretty much controlling the dynamics. So let's just add a de-esser while we're here. We're going to go to dynamics and hit de-esser 2. What I like doing is finding where the S's are.
Say how I feel. I'm heartless, so I
right
think
there.
I'm fucking. When I'm down, I feel alive.
This is the annoying part, so I like opening up EQ and just finding where this annoying sound is at. Right there it is. All right, you hear how annoying that is? All right, so it's at 8700. So we're going to take that EQ off, and we're going to go on our de-esser, type in 8700. And a filter, we're going to do a notch. This little notch means that we would be one of these little notches. So at this, every time that S hits, it's gonna do doop, it's gonna boop, bop, boop, it's gonna go down. You see? I like to have absolute mode on, and then so we're gonna now loop like two bars.
I'm heartless, so I think I'm fucking hard. Say how I feel, but you don't ever get the concept. The dark in my mind, almost as black as my new car tank. Got stars in my eyes, so sweet but feel I'm fucking hard.
So now we control those S's. Now whenever they happen, they're dipping down. If you still hear too much S's, all you're gonna change, mess with, is this filter. You know, just play around with these. Everybody's S's are different, but it's, you can find it using an EQ, and then the rest is pretty much, you know, just tweaking until you like it. I appreciate you guys for watching this video so much. If you're interested in free vocal presets, you can always check the link in my description. I have so much free stuff. It's awesome that to be able to give back to the community. And if you have any questions at all, please feel free to comment them down below. I answer my comments every single day. If you want to, you know, build a relationship with me, hit me up on Instagram. It really does go down on the DMs. I like meeting new artists and collabing with new people. The next video of this series will be adding excitement to your vocal and really giving it that rich, high-end sound. Super excited about that. And then we're going to probably get into vocal effects and then mixing ad-libs and dubs and then mastering. So if you guys enjoyed this, make sure you smash that like button and turn that blue. And if you're not subscribed, I don't know what you're doing anymore. I work so hard for these videos and 76% of people are not subscribing. So if you could smash that subscribe button, I promise I'll make you proud. I promise I'll be the most consistent YouTuber you ever see in your life. We're coming out with 3 YouTube videos every single week, and we're live streaming multiple times a week on YouTube. We're averagely getting 20 to 30 people as of right now. So please join. We're listening to your music and giving you feedback, and we're really building a community. And to get updated, to know when I go live, all you gotta do is hit that post notification bell next to the subscribe button, and you'll get notified every time I go live. I'm telling you, it's so much fun, and it's so much fun to do this with a community of talented individuals. So I will see you guys next video. Peace.